Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the in time, behold him come, offspring of a virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail incarnate deity. Please this man with us to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Happy Christmas to all of you. My dear sisters and brothers, as we continue to be in the Christmas octave, I wish you the peace and joy that Christmas brings us. And today being the first Sunday after Christmas, we also celebrate the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. A family very unlike our families, a family that is all holy, but a family that teaches us that we can make our families holy by tending to what is unholy in them. And so, to God, who is in his person, the Father, the Son, and the Spirit between them, a family, let us together give glory. Let us pray. O God, who were pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and in the bonds of charity, and so, in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision, saying, "Fear not, Abram. I am your shield. I will make your reward very great." But Abram said, "O Lord God, what good will your gifts be if I keep on being childless and have as my heir the steward of my house, Eliezer?" Abram continued, "See, you have given me no offspring, and so one of my servants will be my heir." Then the word of the Lord came to him, "No, that one shall not be your heir. Your own issue shall be your heir." The Lord took Abram outside and said, "Look up at the sky and count the stars if you can. Just so," he added, "shall your descendants be." Abram put his faith in the Lord, who credited it to him as an act of righteousness. The Lord took note of Sarah, as he said he would. He did for her as he had promised. Sarah became pregnant and bore Abraham a son in his old age at the set time that God had stated. Abraham gave the name Isaac to this son of his, whom Sarah bore him. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Oh, blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Oh, blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hand you shall eat. Blessed are those.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, by faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. He went out, not knowing where he was to go. By faith, he received the power to generate, even though he was past the normal age, and Sarah herself was sterile. For he thought that the one who had made the promise was trustworthy. So it was that there came forth from one man, himself as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and as countless as the sands on the seashore. By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was ready to offer his only son, of whom it was said, "Through Isaac, descendants shall bear your name." He reasoned that God was able to raise even from the dead, and he received Isaac back as a symbol. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the days were completed for their purification, according to the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A happy Christmas to all of you. And happy feast of the Holy Family. My dear sisters and brothers, today, as we celebrate the Holy Family and turn our attention to Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, I'd like to, for a change, turn our gaze towards St. Joseph. Poor St. Joseph, talking of Jesus and his mother Mary, is often left in the background. In fact, that is how he is portrayed also in many of these greeting cards. And maybe that was his calling. And remaining in the background, what does he do? Everything. And what does he say? Nothing. But then, as you take a closer look at St. Joseph, the one word that seems to be his response to God seems to be yes. And so, as we complete the year 2020 and are about to step into the new year 2021, let's take on this attitude of St. Joseph. Thanks for all that has been, and yes to all that will be. And on this occasion, I'd like to remind you that Pope Francis has declared this new liturgical year from December 2020 to December 2021 as the year of St. Joseph. And so, allow me to share with you one quality or one virtue of St. Joseph. I say one because St. Joseph's virtue is often neglected, forgotten, or sidelined. And so it is less emphasized and more light is shown on our Blessed Mother and on her son. If St. Joseph were to say something to us, I believe he would look to us and say, in our relationship with God, our hearts may be without words, but our words should never be without the heart. I repeat, in our relationship with God, our heart could be without words, but our words should never be without the heart. This is something you and I see in St. Joseph time and again. The word of the Lord comes to St. Joseph when he finds himself in a predicament, when he is all confused and all messed up and doesn't know which way to turn to. And the moment his word of God comes to him in a dream, the evangelists would tell us that Joseph rose and did what the angel of the Lord ordered him to do. St. Joseph was truly a yes man. And the angel of the Lord would appear to him 5 times, if not 7 times, and tell him which road to take and what turn to make and what he had to do. And St. Joseph always responded with that attitude of yes. But today, I'd like to single out and highlight for you this virtue of St. Joseph, his silence. He doesn't speak a word. And the man is so very silent that he doesn't even speak out his yes. And he does what God wants him to do, and he does it right away. That imminence of his action to his yes is what makes the world of difference in the sanctity and holiness and uniqueness of St. Joseph. And so today, I ask you, how much of silence is there in your life? I realize the irony. I'm talking and talking and talking about silence, right? Well, how else can I convey this to you? And so, bear with me. Our world is filled with noise. So much so, we call it a noisy world. And even our minds and hearts are filled with sounds and sighs. Something goes on all the time. We are listening to this and listening to that and the other, and at the end of the day, we find no time to listen to God. St. Cyprian would say, when we use words and communicate with God, we talk to God. But when we silence our minds and our hearts and listen to God, that's when God speaks to us. It seems that St. Joseph knew that art, that spirituality, and that is why he listened with all his heart, with all his soul. Soren Kierkegaard, the Danish philosopher, said, the whole world and all our life seems to be diseased, sick. And if I were a doctor, I would say, bring the world to silence. Bring silence to the world. And he would go on to elaborate. The word of God can be heard and listened to and learned and discerned only in the silence of the heart. And when we talk, when we chatter, we are distracted, we lose sight of God, and we miss out on God who is passing by. My dear sisters and brothers, how silent are you? Do you make time for silence in your day? Do you begin with a little bit of silence? And do you end and bring your day to completion with a little silence? I remember the time I was in the aspirantate, or even earlier, in the eighth grade. That's when, by the way, I started learning English. And in our school, Salesian School, Don Bosco School, we kids weren't allowed to speak anything but English. And so, when we spoke in the vernacular, did I say vernacular? Well, I don't like that word because it literally means language of the slaves. And when we spoke in our own regional language, we were forced to carry a little tablet. And it read in many ways. And one of them was, I remember carrying it many a time, help, help, I can't stop talking. And I think that is so very true even for us when we grow up. Our minds keep chatting and chattering and talking all the time, and there is no silence in our mind, no silence in our heart. And how do we listen to God? Sisters and brothers, silence is a virtue. Silence is a way to holiness. Silence is a step that takes us closer to God. And today, St. Joseph, the patron of the church, the saint of the year, reminds us that in our relationship with God, our hearts may be without words, but our words should never be without the heart. And so, how about setting aside a few moments of silence each day, either morning or in the evening? It may be good to begin the day in silence and to end the day in silence. Let's pause for a while and pray for this grace, that like St. Joseph, we may be able to silence our minds and our hearts and be able to tune in to the Word of God. You remember what Jesus said? Blessed are those who hear the Word of God and do it. Elsewhere he said, it's not those who cry out, Lord, Lord, who will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only those who hear the Word of God and act on it. And St. Joseph did precisely that, because silence was his virtue, a way for him to listen to God and to draw closer to God. Let's fall silent and pray for this grace. Let's rise and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As we celebrate the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, let's raise our prayers and petitions for our own families. Let your response be, Lord, bless us with your grace.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For the Church, that God will form us into a family of faith that encourages and supports one another in living the gospel more fully each day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For our nation, that God will open our hearts to truly hear one another at this time of transition and change, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For our parish community of St. John Vianney, that the Spirit will guide us in praying together as a community and help us to listen to God's response in the quiet of our hearts and in our experiences of each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For all mothers, that the Son of Mary will help them to love their children unselfishly and encourage them in the Christian way. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For all fathers, that the Son of the Carpenter will fill them with wisdom as they seek to guide and accompany their children towards maturity and wholeness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For all who have no families, that those who have been orphaned, alienated, or rejected by their families may experience love, acceptance, and belonging through this Christian community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For all those of our parish community who are ill, in particular, Bob Mason, Diane Velahovic, June Verish, Ed Wumali, Margaret Roth, Rosita and Avelino Alves, George Greer, Jiri Luong, Ed Uvis, Ed Regan, Leopoldo Miguel, Barbara Harris, Kim Chi Liu, Jerry Mellon, Nikki Nakatani, Jim Crowley, Diego Medina, John Babcock, Andy and Laura Mirabito, Anthony Cristoforo, and Dick Bale. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
For all the deceased members of our families, of our parish community, and in particular for Charity Hartman, Barbara Donovan, mother of Kelly Jones, and Barbara Vizanco, sister-in-law of Elena Vizanco, and Jojo Lascuna, nephew of Rita Yalung, that the risen Lord will welcome them and share eternal life with them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
And we pray in a special way for the repose of the soul of Richard Walsh, Jim Wigner, and Mark Skiles, whom we remember in a special way this weekend, and for the special intentions of Joanne O'Malley Cooper, that God may bless her with his grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
Let's pause for a while and pray for all the members of the staff, for all the pastoral leadership, and certainly for all the ministers in our parish community who contributed so much towards the successful celebration of Christmas. They gave of their time, of their energy, of their skill. And many families in our parish also contributed financially. Let's pray that God, who is never outdone in generosity, we bless them. For this we pray.
Lord, bless us with your grace.
We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
As we are about to offer the Lord the gifts of bread and wine, let's offer with them also our efforts to a meaningful celebration of Christmas. Many of you contributed in many ways, and we thank you for your generosity. May God bless you and keep you. Pray, dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, And with all the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Michael our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, our parents, sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her beloved spouse, with St. John Vianney, Don Bosco, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may come to be co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As we celebrate the Feast of the Holy Family, let's sum up our prayers for all the families of our parish community and certainly for the family of St. John Vianney as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
As you engage in spiritual communion today, it may be a good idea to pray for those in your family who may be the most in need of prayers at the moment. Let's pray for them with all our heart. As we celebrate St. Joseph during this year that is dedicated to him and to his memory, I'd like to invite Deacon Herb Casey to sing the praise of St. Joseph, the song of Joseph.
Could it be this baby in my arms? sleeping now so peacefully. The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? Lord, I know he's not my own, not of my flesh, not of my bone. Still, Father, let this baby be the son of my love. Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. And when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be? Fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? How could it be? This baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully. The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? How could it be?
Let us pray. Bring those you refresh with heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to wish everyone a happy Feast of the Holy Family. It's the feast day of our families here at St. John Vianney. And I want to let you know that this Friday, January 1st, is the Solemnity of Mary, Mother of God. And we will have our traditional 10 a.m. Mass. It will be out front of the church. It will be our only Mass of the day. And we will also have an online Mass, which will run at that same time at 10 a.m. on New Year's Day. So please join us. Thank you.
Today being the first Sunday after Christmas, I'd like to thank all of you for your presence in the family of St. John Vianney. for your participation in the preparations for Christmas, the actual celebration of Christmas too. May God bless you. Many of you gave in many ways. There are those that gave their time, others that gave their talents, and still others were there present doing things. And of course, most families pitched in when it came to money and money offering, and we are very grateful to you for helping us to continue the works of God. May God bless all of you. Being Christmas, I would also like to extend my gratitude to all the liturgical ministers, those that prepared the liturgy proper, the singing, the music, the church environment, and also other ministers like greeters and ushers and money counters, the sacristans, and everyone. May God bless you. We are a family, and it's all in the family to belong and to take the responsibility. And as part of the leadership, I'd like to say a big thank you to all of you. May God bless you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let us our songs employ. Old fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth.